Windows 11. It sucks. Lots of bloat, performance hogs, spyware, telemetry, all that crap. But it doesn't have to be that way. So here's a quick and dirty guide to make your Windows 11 slightly more tolerable. This should apply to 95 to 99% of you, especially those who are stuck with Windows and can't use macOS or Linux for whatever reason. For those of you who haven't installed Windows 11 yet, you can get the Windows ISOs from the official channels or in the Massgrave dev website. Some people recommended installing the LTSC version rather than the regular version. In fact, you might as well ditch Windows 11 in favor of Windows 10 LTSC version because that still receives support until 2032. LTSC version is the long-term support channel version, which is a version of the OS that will have a longer-term support compared to the original. The LTSC version doesn't have Windows Store and has less bloatware and apps pre-installed. It's meant to be installed in devices where they must remain constant, like cashiers or IoT stuff. But the biggest weakness of LTSC versions is that modern games and software might not support that. You can read the details in the Massgrave dev page linked below. Personally, I recommend most people to stay with the normal, non-LTSC Windows 11, unless you know what you're doing, or you're willing to accept the risk of instability issues and apps not being compatible. Besides, most laptops will come with the non-LTSC version. I know, because I sell these. I will be talking about the non-LTSC version because that's the version that most people will most likely get out of the box of their brand new laptops or PCs. When you boot up your new PC or laptop for the first time with Windows 11 installed, every single one of us should always perform this essential command. Press Shift F10, type in OOBE/bypassNRO, / not forward slash, and you can proceed to Windows 11 without the internet and an offline account, as how it's supposed to be done. This command is so essential that employees of PC and laptop retailers that I worked for are trained to do these commands for every new PC or laptop. I'm not kidding. Windows 11 installation process is so stupid that retail employees had to be trained on how to bypass the online requirement by hacking through Windows using CMD. Now that you know how to do it, proceed through the installation as how you normally would. And don't forget to disable these options so that you can tell Windows not to spy on you. That's only the beginning of preventing Microsoft to spy on your activities. It isn't just a matter of privacy. Even if you're a public figure who doesn't mind Microsoft spying on you, it's also a matter of wasting PC resources on spying and hogging your gaming or working performance in the process. The less spying, the less privacy being violated, the less resources to waste, and the more performance to gain somewhere else. And so, Windows 11 begins, and here's what I always do after I see the desktop. First thing that I like to do is to modify the looks to my liking, like getting compact view in the File Explorer and modifying the taskbar so that it's left-sided and has less garbage in the middle. Second is to disable the fancy animations by right-clicking the computer, properties, advanced system settings, and follow these settings. Or not, it's up to you, but this is what I always do every time, and I just want my Windows to look snappy and without any obnoxious animations. Third is to separate the partition of my single NVMe drive and move the documents, pictures, music, and videos folder to the new partition. That way, if I want to wipe out my operating system, these are still safe. All you need is to click on the library, change the folder to the new drive, and you're good to go. Fourth, I right-click on the start menu, go to installed apps, and then I go to the list of apps and uninstall everything I don't need, especially antivirus. Windows Defender is fine. Antivirus is just more performance hogs to the system. And finally, connect to the internet and let Windows 11 to update to the latest version. Windows updates sucks, but they are necessary, which is why you should just let your computer run the updates. After the update, I go to the privacy settings and disable everything that I don't need. The less you let Windows spy on you, the less resources it will use to spy on you, and therefore, better performance. Here's another thing that annoys me with Windows Update. I recently bought and tweaked this laptop for a client of mine before I'm ready to ship it to them. This laptop has Windows 11 pre-installed, but it's version 22H2, not the latest one at the time of writing, which is 24H2. Okay, if it's not the 22H2, then I could just run Windows Update and let them update to 24H2, right? Wrong! If you're running Windows version 22H2, Windows Update just said, your version of Windows has reached the end of service. then let me update it to the next version that still has the updates. Is 22H2 that radically different to 24H2? Not really, but it is according to Microsoft. Because of that, you really need to use the Windows 11 Installation Assistant to upgrade your old Windows 11 22H2 installation to the latest version. That's right, you have to download an external app to update your Windows. What's the point of having Windows Update if it can't even update? Why do I have to download an external Windows program to update to a major version of Windows? That's the job that I'm tasking Windows Update for. Even smartphones can do major Android and UI updates in their built-in updater. Why can't Windows do that? And you wonder why people tell Windows Update to shut up. Typical Microsoft, right? A couple steps forward and several steps back. Ugh. Anyway, let's get back to the guide. Time to get some programs for your brand new Windows 11 installation. Do you want an all-in-one install for all the apps? Use the Chris Titus Tech Windows Utility. Look it up on GitHub. You can run them by copying this command and pasting them to PowerShell. Remember, it needs to run as administrator. Here are all the apps that you might need. Just click on the ones you need and they'll install them for you. If the apps you see are not there, look them up and download them yourself. Oh, and here's one more thing you need to double check after you install these apps. Right click on the taskbar, click Task Manager, and click this icon to see the startup apps. If you see any apps that start with Windows that you don't need, right click and disable them so that it doesn't start with Windows. The less apps running, the better your performance will be. The less apps running in startup for no reason, the better your performance will be when you start. There are many ways to tweak your Windows performance. Uninstall the apps that you don't need so they don't hog a lot of space, and make sure that the apps that you do install don't run automatically when you start off Windows. The less apps start with Windows, the better. But these are all just basics. Here's a more advanced tweak. Using the Chris Titus Tech Windows Utility, most of the tweaks for Windows 11 that 99% of people need are all here. Just go to the Tweaks section and pick the tweaks that you like. Oh, actually, before you apply these tweaks, make sure you update Windows 11 to the latest version, because Windows might revert some of these back to the original once you update. Keep that in mind. I'll start off by applying the standard setup and then continue picking the tweaks that I either need or don't need. For most people, standard is fine, but if you want more or if you want less, you can opt for any other options there. Once you are done, just click Run Tweaks. There's also this utility called OOShutUp10, bundled with Chris Titus Tech Utility, but you can also get it separately. This will let you disable all the spying that came with Windows 11. You can enable all the recommended ones, or you can manually enable or disable one by one. Once again, Windows Update will revert some of these back to the original, which is why I recommend you update Windows to the latest version before you apply these tweaks. So you have to boot up after an update and change it back. Thankfully, you can save your own custom preset option, so you can use this however you like. Once you apply all these tweaks, reboot your PC, and you're good to go. From this point on, everything that I just said before, I recommend everyone to do. Some of the old tweaks that I suggested back in my old videos are still true. You can definitely go and check them out if you want specifics. But for your general information, here are all the apps that I recommend to make your Windows 11 better. I've talked about Chris Titus Tech's Windows Utility and OOShutUp10, but here are a couple of Windows apps that you might find interesting to customize your Windows experience. Wiz3. If you have lots of stuff in your hard drive, but you want to know which one consumes your hard drive the most, then Wiz3 is the app for you. AltSnap. This lets you move and resize Windows around by holding the Alt key, like Linux. It's pretty cool. Ear Trumpet. It's a volume mixer that lets you control the volumes of all the apps that are open. I highly recommend this, especially for streamers. Win Arrow Tweaker. Loads of tools and customizations here, like reducing menu show delays and reducing window border. I highly recommend it. But it really needs an update, because some of the tweaks there are not working on Windows 11 at the time of writing. Maybe when you're watching this, it already works. WinToys. It's a nice little app that lets you control all sorts of things in your Windows 11, including classic context menu, ads, etc. PowerToys. Loads and loads of tools you can use here. I cannot recommend it enough if you really want to boost your productivity. everything. It's an app that lets you to search literally everything on your PC in an instant. I use this app to search for clips that I saved on my streams. I highly recommend this one. Also, if you want that integrated with the Windows search function, there's the Everything toolbar. File Converter. It lets you convert files super quick with just a right click. Explorer Patcher. If you really don't like Windows 11's taskbar, this lets you to revert that taskbar back to the Windows 10 version, which still exists there somehow. Windows 11 Disable Rounded Corners. It lets you to remove the rounded corners and replace them with sharp ones. OpenShell. If you don't like Windows 11's start menu, you could use OpenShell and get an old school looking start menu instead. Apparently, this doesn't work with Windows ARM Edition at the moment, so definitely keep that in mind. And finally, Free Media Heck Yeah. It's an all-in-one resource website where I got most of the stuff here. Give this one a visit if you want more guides and resources for these sorts of tweaks. And that's all for the video today. Thank you all so much for watching. If you made it to the end, here's a cat. Before we close this video, huge thanks to all these wonderful sponsors. You are all fantastic. If you want to see your name among these legends, then check out the links below, just $1. And you have supported this channel a lot. Seriously, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you all next time.